Google Bard is revolutionizing the AI industry, and recently it got an amazing upgrade that will change the way how people use it. This update gives Bard a new ability to understand and use different kinds of information, like text and images. So join us in this video and watch till the end, as you are about to see why Bard is amazing. You might already be familiar with ChatGPT, which is very skilled at many tasks. However, Bard is just as useful as ChatGPT, especially for things like internet research and now working with images. Bard keeps getting better with regular updates. You can see the list of changes here. Just a few days ago, Bard gained the ability to work with more than 40 new languages. Now, you can include pictures along with text when you talk to Bard. This opens up new possibilities for creativity and thinking. It's also neat that Bard can read responses out loud. Some might argue that when we compare Bard to the latest GPT-4 on specific technical tests, Bard doesn't seem as impressive. But it's important to realize that the world of AI is diverse. Each AI tool has its own strengths and weaknesses, and there are areas where one AI is better than another. For instance, when we talk about ChatGPT, we acknowledge it as one of the smartest AI systems. However, it has a limitation. It doesn't have the latest or updated information, and browsing with Bing is disabled. Even when Bing was available, it wasn't very fast. On the other hand, if you use Bard to search the internet, it's much faster in providing certain types of answers, and it has the most recent information on every article. With ChatGPT and Bing, sometimes it would try to open a link and it would say couldn't read, the content failed. This doesn't happen with Bard. So, Bard has specific strengths that I want to highlight. This should hopefully change your perspective and show that it's not ideal to restrict oneself to just one AI tool. There are different tools for different tasks. The main idea here is that there are various AIs designed for different purposes, and you'll be more efficient if you know which one to use for a specific situation. Currently, the only multimodal AI available to the public is Bard, and as we've mentioned before, it's not as widely recognized as it should be. Let's take a look at what the community is doing with Bard. I believe it's a better tool for finding updated information on the internet compared to ChatGPT or even Bing. When you go to Bard, you'll notice a new user interface. There's a button that allows you to easily upload a file. Clicking on it, you'll see you can upload almost any image. One thing Bard recently added, which should have been there from the start, is the ability to search through your chats and view your chat history. While it's fun to experiment with, please avoid submitting any personal information when working with images. They are reviewing the training data that's submitted, and they'll make adjustments based on Bard's responses. This means human reviewers will see the data you enter. A user submitted two images to Bard to see how well it recognizes them. The first image is a 3D render of a house. Bard's recognition is quite accurate, describing the image as a transparent PNG of a 3D model with a garage. It mentions some trees and shrubs, which aren't actually there. This could be a problem if someone visually impaired relies on this software. We know that Bard's recognition is still being fine-tuned, but it's clear that the competition between Microsoft and Google is pushing features forward faster than expected. While Google announced Bard's image capabilities at Google I/O, we didn't anticipate it being available so quickly. OpenAI has been working on images for a while, but they haven't released the model yet. It's currently only available to a select group of Bing users. If you are enjoying it so far, make sure to like this video, hit that subscribe button, and ring that notification bell so you never miss out on the latest AI-related videos. Currently, I believe they are conducting alpha testing to make sure the AI is safe for everyone to use and to prevent any misuse. You see, there can be various ways people might try to exploit AIs. So here, a user decided to send a basic picture of Sonic. The AI described the image as a blue cartoon character on a black background. However, it's actually a transparent background, which can sometimes appear black. Nevertheless, the AI correctly identified the character as Sonic the Hedgehog, I think based on some available information. What Google has done is essentially combined its reverse image search feature with the input image. If you're not familiar with Google's reverse image search, it's a tool where you can upload an image to find similar ones. For instance, if someone were to upload the same picture of Sonic here, I believe a variety of search results would show up. To make this process quicker, Google provides a summary of some of the top search results. This seems to be quite effective. This also indicates that Google is very determined to outperform OpenAI. It shows that Google has accelerated the pace of their development and is ambitious in what they want to achieve with their AI programs. Now, let's look at what the community has accomplished with BARD. While my examples are straightforward, there are more complex experiments being shared on Twitter. For instance, a user conducted one of the most impressive experiments. This stands out because it directly compares GPT-4's image search capabilities. In the GPT-4 trailer, Greg Brockman, co-founder of OpenAI, showcased the future capabilities of GPT-4. He took a photo of a roughly drawn mock-up and instantly transformed it into a functional website. We started with a basic version to compare. We progressed from a hand-drawn design, which I must say looked quite nice, to a fully functional website. After watching the demonstration, let's examine another attempt at using BARD for a similar task. This person decided to create their own rough version of the website, and it seems to have worked. Essentially, they incorporated their sketch, which you can all see. Additionally, they included a prompt instructing to create a simple HTML JavaScript code to transform the colorful mockup into a real website with two actual jokes. What's noteworthy is that if you receive drafts that aren't quite accurate, like when ChatGPT generates faulty code, you can easily click the Regenerate Draft button or explore other drafts to find a suitable code. BARD's strength lies in its ability to instantly provide three different variations, a feature lacking in ChatGPT, which requires regenerating the entire response. I suspect the reason for this trio of drafts might be a form of reinforcement learning through user feedback. Google likely analyzes which draft users prefer in specific situations, aiming to understand what makes that response superior. This ongoing process is bound to enhance BARD's effectiveness over time. The final version you see here actually works. When he reveals the punchline, it works perfectly. This shows that while BARD's coding abilities aren't considered the best, they're still quite good. You can create functional code for basic things. However, we're not really making websites like this anymore, so its uses may be limited. But it's impressive to see that BARD is still being improved quickly. A Twitter user demonstrated something really cool using BARD. It's worth noting that I was initially going to mention GPT-4, but this is actually Google's BARD. He wanted to recreate the iPhone timer app. He provided clear instructions. Recreate the app in this screenshot. Make sure it works properly. Give all the necessary code for it to function. Write your code in Swift UI without any errors. BARD got to work as instructed. He then imported it into Swift UI. The user copied and pasted the code, but there were some things that needed fixing. If you've ever done coding, you'll know it's not always straightforward. Eventually, the build was successful, meaning the app actually works. Just like that, he managed to code this simple app in seconds. If you are still watching it, make sure to like this video, hit that subscribe button, and ring that notification bell so you never miss out on the latest AI-related videos. For those who might doubt BARD's reliability, thinking, "I can't get the code to work," it's worth acknowledging that this achievement is quite impressive. Just a year ago, Google didn't have a large language model like this, and now they've created a product with advanced coding capabilities despite fierce competition. While Bing's multimodal capabilities are expected to be outstanding, it's fascinating that Google, who was once lagging in AI, has become a tough competitor to ChatGPT. Google Bard is still under development, but it's already capable of doing amazing things. I'm excited to see what the future holds for this powerful AI language model. So, what are your thoughts on Bard? Let me know down in the comments below. And just before you go, take a look at how other companies are boosting their AI.